Hello students, I am Nidhi Srivastava from Sheth Vidya Mandir English High School and Junior College. Today I am going to teach you Computer Science for Standard 3rd, Chapter 1, Introduction to Computers. So let's start. This is the pic of computer and its parts. Introduction to Computers. What is a computer? A computer is a machine made up of parts that help you enter data, process it, give the result as output, and store it. See? Uses of computers. Computers can be used to draw pictures, solve sums, play games, listen to music, etc. Computers are also used to carry out various tasks in schools, offices, railway stations, airports, hospitals, banks, etc. A computer is made up of hardware and software. What is hardware? Hardware refers to those parts of a computer that you can touch or feel. A CPU, monitor, keyboard, or mouse, etc. are examples of computer hardware. This is the pics of computer hardware. Software. Software refers to a set of instructions or commands given to a computer. These instructions are then used to carry out tasks in a computer. Some of the popular software are MS Office 2013, Microsoft Windows, KTurtle, etc. Software. These are the pics. Computer instructions or data, anything that can be stored electronically is software. Examples: MS Word, Excel, PowerPoint, spreadsheets, library management system, etc. Starting a computer. Let us first learn how to start a computer stepwise. Step 1, switch on the power supply. Step 2, switch on the UPS. Step 3, switch on the power button on the CPU cabinet. Step 4, switch on the monitor. After some time, a screen will appear. It is called desktop. See, this is the pic of desktop, which is the first pic of computer when it starts. Now, data. Data refers to a collection of facts like your name, marks, telephone number, etc. Data is entered into a computer by typing it using the keyboard. The data entered is called the input. Input devices. An input device is used to enter data or instructions into a computer. Commonly used input devices are the keyboard and the mouse. This is the pic of keyboard and mouse, we all know. Keyboard. A keyboard is a device with a number of keys on it. We type by pressing the keys on a keyboard. Using a keyboard, you can type letters and numbers on the computer screen. Mouse. A computer mouse is normally connected by a cable to a computer. It helps us point to items on the monitor. A mouse may have 2 or 3 buttons. The most commonly used mouse today is the scroll mouse, which has 2 buttons and a scroll wheel at the center. Mouse actions. First, click. To click, gently press the left mouse button once and release it. This action selects an item on the monitor. Double click. To double click, press the left mouse button twice quickly and release it. This action helps you open a file, a folder, or a program. Right click. To right click, press and release the right mouse button once. It shows the list of commands. Drag and drop. We use the drag and drop action to move an item from one position to another on the monitor using a computer mouse. Processing data. Performing calculations or comparing data is called processing. It refers to the action taken on the data. If you want to add two numbers, say 72 and 92, type the number and instruct the computer to add them. The computer will process this data and display the result 164. Central Processing Unit, that is CPU. CPU controls all the functions of a computer, so it is also called the brain of a computer. The CPU cabinet contains the CPU. The CPU consists of three parts. Number one, arithmetic logical unit, that is ALU. Number two, control unit, that is CU. And number three, register. Now, this is the pic of CPU. Arithmetic logic unit, ALU. The ALU does all the arithmetic calculations and logical comparisons. The arithmetic calculations include addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, etc. Control unit, CU. The control unit controls the movement of information between the register, the ALU, and the other parts of the computer. Register. A register is a small memory unit in the CPU. This is where all the data that will be processed is stored. The register helps the ALU to access this data easily for calculations and helps the control unit to quickly pass on this data to other parts of the computer. Now, output devices. The result given by the computer after processing data is known as output. Output device is used to display the output on the computer. Some examples are the monitor, the printer, and the speakers. These are the pick of output devices. We can see speaker, monitor, headphone, plotter, projector, and printer. Now, monitor. A monitor is also known as the visual display unit, VDU, of a computer. It displays the result of the task performed by a computer. We can also watch movies and cartoon films on a monitor. The output seen on the monitor is called the soft copy. Printer. Printer is used to print, usually on paper, the output that you see on a monitor. This printout is called the hard copy. Speakers. We use speakers to listen to music and other sounds from a computer. Storing data. Computers can store a large amount of data, but where does it all go? Let us learn about it. Memory. A computer memory is a part where it stores all the information and data. We can access this memory and refer to the information stored in it. The information in the memory can be changed or erased too. Types of memory. There are two main types of memory in a computer. Primary memory, also called main memory, and secondary memory. Primary or main memory. Main memory is what the computer uses when it is on. When you open a file, a folder, or a program, the computer places it in main memory. Main memory does not hold data after the computer is switched off. This is the pic of main memory. Secondary memory. If you give the command to save a file, the file will be stored in secondary memory. This is usually a hard disk placed inside the cabinet containing the CPU. You can also store data on floppy disks, pen drives, CDs, that is compact disks, and DVDs, digital versatile disks, which are also called secondary storage devices. is the peak of secondary memory. This is where our program and data are saved for long-term purposes. Shutting down a computer. To shut down a computer, follow these steps. First, click the start button. Then, a menu will appear. Click on the shut down button. A message appears showing that the system is logging off and then shutting down. Third, now switch off the power button on the monitor. Number four, switch off the UPS. Number five, switch off the power supply. Note, the power supply is usually kept on to keep the UPS in a charged state. This is the pic which shows shutting down of the computer. Thank you, students.